Thank you for joining us today. We're joined by Yasmin Petrantonio, Adrian McGarrigle, Tess Jadlew, and head coach Tara Zollinger. We'll begin with an opening statement from Coach Zollinger and then move into questions. Coach, please give us a brief opening statement.
Sure. ESU played a fantastic game. Their game plan defensively was really tough. And we knew that going into this game that it was going to be a very difficult game, because every time we play against ESU, we're rivals, it's a battle. So we knew that the difference was going to be our mindset, and the team going into this game picked specific words that they needed in that mindset, and I'm really proud of them. It was the intangibles today, where they were able to come back from being down 1-0 and then to win it 2-1. So really proud of the way that they dug deep and they played to that mindset.
We're now open for questions.
Okay. All right. Adrian is the local player. I'm the local writer. So you're going back to the championship game. You've been there and won it as a freshman. Can you talk about maybe what that experience was like and the ability of going back, though?
Freshman year was simply like a movie. It was festival, all the schools there. Like, I felt like I was living the dream. Like, we were playing for something bigger than ourselves. We had our super senior and Moody, and it's just like we all really wanted it. Practices were hard, but we knew we needed to do. And like, I feel like I took what I learned from freshman year. I know everybody does. I want my freshmen, our freshmen, to experience that same feeling.
I'll go ahead. Tess, I want to ask you about just if you could describe the goals, certainly that you scored, but also at the same time, too, just patience, and you guys just kept at it and kept at it and kept at it, and the opportunities then came.
I think it was like a tough game at the beginning, especially when we were like 1-0, and I think it was pretty hard for us, but we knew we could do it, and it's just everyone wants it so bad, we trained so hard, and we just keep turning over, and then one ball, and then it's coming, and it's just incredible. I don't know how to feel, it was amazing.
Yeah, as I kind of want to ask you about the same thing, just about, again, sticking to it, and there's adversity that comes the way, and then weathering that and keeping at it and, you know, sticking to it for 60 minutes.
Yeah, when we went to halftime, we knew we could get the job done, but that wasn't enough. This time we actually had to do it. And in the PSAC tournament, both games we came back from behind. We were losing against Millersville 1-0, and we were losing against Westchester, and we were losing today too. It's all about the resiliency and the intangibles that this team carries. You know, we always talk about, it's not about us, it's not about us 11 on the field, it's not about us 30 as a team, it's not about the staff, it's about the people who came before us and all those that are gonna come after us. We are playing with all those and every single one of them. And at the end of the day, it's who wants it the most, and we want it the most. We want this the most. And I think that at the end of the day, you can fight against it.
Coach, I want to sneak one in your way, and I want to ask you about sort of defense becoming offense. The play that stood out to me was about 9 minutes going forth. Torrey Albright won a ball around midfield, dribbled about 40 yards down the field, earned a corner off of that. You couldn't score off of that, but then after they countered, Merrill won a ball back in the other backfield, sent it down, I think, to Yaz, and sent it to Moore, I think, and then we earned a couple more corners eventually off of that. And that really helped you with possession. Like, because it really, you know, for that stretch of possession, it really, I think, helped with momentum. But even sometimes when the offense is down there, but your defense, it sometimes helps create those opportunities as well, and I wanted to ask you just about maybe that.
Yeah, absolutely. So we always say our attack starts with our backs on our outlet or on our midfield attack. They set the tempo, they set the pace, and they all have really good, strong, basic skills. And you need strong, basic skills to play the style of hockey that we play. So they're just as capable as our mids and our forwards to run hard on the baseline and to earn those types of corners. I think that their calmness, like they were so calm on the ball this game. The first half, we were under a lot of pressure, and that was a big adjustment for us in the second half, was you guys you got to trust your abilities, you got to stay calm on the ball, you got to move the ball. They did that really well, and you did exactly what you said. They opened up some attack plays for the mids and the forwards to finish on.
And just one last thing off of that, too, passing, because Sarah Womer is the one really that helps set up the second goal there, too, to test just her stick-to-itiveness outside the circle. Like, again, just in this weather and the conditions and everything, it's connecting the passes is just as important, too, you'd say, correct?
Yes, absolutely. And they have a lot of confidence in each other's ability. And so when someone's calling for the ball, they know that if I get them the ball where they need it, they're going to maintain possession of the ball. We work extremely hard on that, and they've proved it all year that Sarah can receive the ball in really nice spaces and turn and make some really great plays. So I think she did a really good job of possessing, and again, she was under really tough pressure by ESU today, and she did a really good job just maintaining possession, staying calm on the ball, and finding her passes from there.
I've been hogging all the questions.
No, you're good. You're good. I'm curiously, ladies, whomever wants to answer, did the fact that you were behind in the PSAC tournament, not once, but twice, help you tonight going into halftime down 1-0?
Oh, yeah. I think so, yeah. We had 30 minutes. We had 30 minutes to put one on the board. That's all we needed, one. And first time around PSAC tournament, we did it in 6 minutes. It's Westchester, we put 3 in 10 minutes. We knew we could get the job done, but we had to do it. Belief is not enough, but belief, it helps you when you actually are determined to do what you have to do.
I apologize. No, coaches, you guys always, you're always worried, if you will, but because what they have shown you so many times in the past, what was the mood, if you will, as far as from the coach's standpoint?
They train a down one mindset. We've trained it the last month of what are we going to do when we're down one, and they proved it. They proved it in 2 really difficult games against conference rivals. So we were confident that they would know that they can rely on that experience and know that, like Yes said, you have the belief, but when you back the belief with hard work, you're going to get it done. And this team is extremely hardworking. So we were confident that they were going to be able to find that equal.